Previously, it would have been really hard to configure a dashboard based on a time backwards or forward based on the date that is today. Luckily, there is a new functionality within Data Studio, which is called the Advanced Date functionality, which we'll now find in all the date pickers that we have in Data Studio. And I asked Ahmad to come up with a little tutorial to show off this new feature and how we can utilize it inside of our dashboards. Now we got lots to cover, so Ahmad, take it away.
Thanks, Julian. This is Ahmed from Sirwalk, and in this video, I'm going to walk you through the Advanced Date Selection feature in Google Data Studio. This is a fairly new feature, and let's dive in and see how it works. This is a blank report that I've made. I've already added a data source, and let's create a time series chart to see what options do we have for selecting the date range. But this is our time series chart. We want to see the number of sessions over time for this website. And by default, the date range that is applied to a chart in Data Studio is auto, a means last 28 days. We have other options as well. So we can choose for this to show other period of time by using custom. Let's see what options do we have. The first one is fixed, which is simple. Instead of last 28 days, we can choose this report to always show, for example, May 1st to May 14th. And regardless of the date that the end user accesses this chart and views this report, they're always going to see the report for 1st of May to 14th of May. This is not dynamic, but we have some dynamic options as well, which are based on the actual date that the report is being accessed. Just like this, last 7 days, last 14 days, last 30 days, and not last 30 days according to today. It is based on the actual date that people access the report. These are the options that we kind of always had in Google Data Studio, such as this week, last week, this month, this quarter, last quarter. But what if we wanted to set the date range for this chart to 2 months ago, until 2 weeks ago? So we couldn't do that. Or let's say we wanted the last 3 weeks, not including the days that have passed from this week. We couldn't do that either. But with the new advanced date selection feature, we can do this and lots more. Let's see what it means. First of all, we need to select the start date. For the start date, we can choose fixed, which is a fixed date. So let's say, for example, we want 1st of January 2019 until last week. Every time we want to load the report, we want to see 1st of January until last week. This is how it's done. So the first day would be 1st of January, fixed, and the end date would be today minus one, not 1 day, 1 week. And we can choose a starting on Sunday or Monday as well. So when I apply this, whenever a user accesses the report, when they're viewing the report, they would see the report is starting from 1st of January, going to the last week, not including the days that have passed from that week. Now let's do something else. Even for the start date, we can have some dynamic value. So let's say we want from 4 weeks ago to last week. That would be today minus 4 weeks to today minus 1 week. We can also have this with quarters, with years, or with months. So from 3 months ago to 1 month ago, minus 1 month. Today, which is the 1st of June, it loads from 1st of February to the end of May. That's cool, isn't it? Now let me show you another usage for the advanced time selector. Let me add another, this time scorecard. And for this, I want the average order value. Let me delete this one. So we just take a look at the average order value here. Okay, this is the average order value. The date range is auto, last 28 days. Okay, but let's think about this hypothetical situation that the client wants to see the performance of their website in terms of average order value over the last 7 days compared to how it used to perform from 1st of January up to last 7 days. So basically, they want to compare last week to the whole period of time from 1st of this year to that point. For this, we want to first set the custom date range for the actual value of this scorecard to be from today, last 7 days. Okay, we wanted to show the average order value for last 7 days. And then we want to compare it to the average order value from the 1st of January up to 8 days ago. For this, enable the comparison. For the comparison, historically we had fixed, we had previous period, which is last 7 days compared to the 7 days before that, or from the same 7 days of previous year. But now we have advanced, and we can choose the start date to be fixed. And for this situation, we want it to be 1st of January. And the end date would be today minus 7 days. Okay. If I hit apply, I will have the comparison. So this is the average order value for the last 7 days. And it's down from the average order value performance over the year up to last 7 days. But this is not clear. So let's go to style and uncheck this. So it actually shows us what the main value is being compared to. So the main value is minus 1.3% down from what we had from 1st of January to 21st of May. And by the way, you can show absolute changes as well. So it is nearly $3 less than the average order value that we had from 1st of January to 21st of May. So as you can see, not only we can use the advanced date range feature for the main scorecard or the main charts that we are using, but also we can use it for a more flexible date ranges for the comparison with previous date ranges. That's it. Thank you for watching and see you on the next video.
All right, so there you have it. This is how you can utilize the new advanced date feature within Data Studio. Now, do you actually utilize this already, or do you have a good use case? I'd love to hear from you down in the comments below. And if you want to find more out about Data Studio, about different features, functions, and so on, we have a playlist on Data Studio right up there where you can find out more with more tutorials. And as always, if you like this video, why not give us a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel, because we bring you new videos just like this one every week. Now, my name is Julian. See you in the next one.